This is the app for the Ezviz C6 2K Plus pan tilt camera. Here we can see this is actually the homepage when you first log into your application. Right here you can see the singular camera from Ezviz that I currently have. Upper right hand corner, plus sign, allows you to add more cameras if you want. Right here, we've got our layout style. So right now I have it on expanded. You can have it on condensed or list view, and then sort by space, device type, and then we can rearrange our spacing. So there's a lot of things that we can do with the app to personalize it. Over here, we have a picture of a person with a red dot. Selecting this brings you into your profile. We'll discuss that a little later. Further down on our page, we have our arm disarm. So if you have several Ezviz cameras, you can arm and disarm them all at once simply by sliding that over to the side to arm everything. But let's get to the actual Ezviz C6 that I have set up right here. You can see in the upper right-hand corner of my little preview window, I have a 7. That lets you know that there are 7 entries that it has captured. Now, when I get to it, I'm going to show you how to turn this on, because if you don't have push notifications sent to your phone, you won't actually get the library or this number up here. This is a arrow, which if we select that, brings us right into the settings for the Ezviz, as opposed to if we just tap on the Ezviz, it brings us into the camera portion first, and we'll just watch that load up. And depending on your network connectivity is how quickly that loads up. So on our main page here, you could see it's letting me know there was a 7-day free trial for the cloud storage, letting me know that kind of expired. I wish there was a way to kind of make that go away, or make the default the actual internal SD card that I have on this. And here it will show you all the clips that I have. And it does take a little bit of time for those to load up, but you'll notice in the lower right-hand corner of some of our videos with the AI, it says, well, a pet and person was detected, a pet and person was detected, and in this one, a pet was detected. You can arrange how you like. So nearby devices, it's showing me there's one, and then I could play that directly from there. We're gonna select back. We can filter, and we can set a specific day if we wanted to. We can search for human detected, hand wave detected, abnormal sound, or pet. So there's a lot of things that we can do with this. I just kind of wish that it would kind of aggregate things a little better, make this banner go away. That's gonna kind of be my overall experience with this app. It does a lot of things, but the layout could be a little better and make it a little easier to find some of these things. So if I come down here and I click on one of my clips, there you'll see it loads it up, and then somewhere in here, a cat will come into view. But if you don't feel like watching or scrubbing through this, and we're just gonna pause that for a moment, we have our 10 second rewind, or while it's playing right here, we have the option to speed things up to almost 16 times faster. And then right here, selecting that icon here, swipes it over to the live view, and then we can go back to our playback, but it also puts us into this view here, which kind of takes up more real estate. Coming back to the live view of our camera, and again, we're gonna pop it over to our SD card, and you can see slowly those things are populating. And you can see it says there's a total of 18 clips in there, and then we have our view events tab right from here, or we can view our events from here. That's our library. Those are our 7 events. So if I come back here, go back to the SD card, again, wish there was a way I could default it to that. If we come and select view events, those are gonna show us our individual events and let us know pet detected. I'm pretty sure I deleted the one with, here we go, human AI. There I am in the background. So lots of things that you can do with your camera and the clips. Tapping on our image here brings up all the things that we can currently do. This is a live feed. I can pause, I can mute the sound, I can bring up my pan tilt commands, I can turn on and off the audio, and there you go. It's talking through the camera. This will expand my live view, take up the full screen, and then this one is picture in picture. You might need to actually turn on your permissions within your smartphone in order to use that, because it will overlay over other apps. And if you're like me on Android, Android doesn't like apps being able to do that by default, and that's a jump out, which is take this image and push it out on its own. There's one other icon right up here. This is actually our settings icon. So we're gonna come all the way down here to the bottom and see what else we have, which is our snapshot that allow us to take an image of what's going on live in our feed here. We can record, again, what's going on live in our feed right here. These are our pan tilt commands. So if I come here, I can use this to move the camera around. I will say, again, depending on your network stability is how quickly and sensitive this actually works. One of the things that I really like about the Ezviz app with the pan tilt stuff is if I hit the bottom one here, notice there it's flashing red. That means it's at the bottom of what it can actually go to. And if I start moving this, see that along the bottom there, that axis, that actually lets you know how far left or right or up and down you can move this. So if I try and pan this up, notice we were over here at the bottom, but I can see just how far I can aim this up at my ceiling. Those are our pan tilt options. And we could just drag that across. We've got our talk, which is very similar to what we touched up here. We have our definition mode right here. So that's ultra, maximum that it can do, full HD, high def, standard. So lots of options for how you want your video to come through. If you don't have great connection speeds, you can lower that in order to save some bandwidth. Here we have privacy mode. I do like this. If we turn on privacy mode, what will happen is the camera itself will rotate up and move it out of the way. So it actually is capturing nothing. And you will see privacy mode is enabled. So you would select disable. It does have a little smiley face on the front as you saw before. We are going to turn off privacy mode to bring us back into our options. There we go. And you can actually see the head rotate down. It is a little slower than other pan tilt cameras that have had this option due to reestablish a connection, but not terrible. Here we have our 360 picture. This is a really interesting thing. If we select 360, what it will do, this is one that I've done before, it will rotate the camera and take a full 360. And there you can see that's me over in the corner there. It will take a 360 picture of everything that's going on, and you could scan through it. And if we touch on certain points in the picture, as you see me double tapping, it will move the camera to those points. So let's say over here, I caught something really weird. I click over there, it moves in. So we can reset the 360 picture, which will have it take another one. Or we've got our link detector, which you can get extra beacons. I don't have that, so I'm just talking about the camera itself. So that's our 360 right there. And then we can rearrange these items as they appear in the bar. So if there's things that you use more often, you can shuffle them around. There's a lot of customization in this app, which I really like. Like I said, I just wish it was a little easier to navigate. But if we come up here and hypothetically make this picture bigger, you can see right here, you have access to all of those options that you had before. You have the ability to go to a playback if there's a specific clip that you wanted to get to. And then you've got your information about the camera itself. Notice there's no actual like Ezviz watermarking on there, which I really appreciate. This is a live feed. And again, I'm getting unstable network connection because I've got too many things going on. But if I double tap, you'll notice nothing happens for the zoom. If I pinch to zoom, you can really see just how close things get. And then you would back it out. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna go back to our view here because those are all our controls and SD card capabilities. Now we actually wanna see our options right up here. Selecting our options, this is where we get into some of the meat of what this can do. First being, you can name your device. Moving down, we have our intelligent detection. So this is gonna be our AI stuff. If we select this, we have the ability to have image change detection. With other cameras that are plug-in, meaning they use electricity, this would be like a pixel-based change. So hypothetically, if this is the image that the camera's seeing, and then this happens, you will get a notification because the pixels have changed. We have our human-based detection right there. And for any of these, if you wanna know how to toggle it on and off, you simply go there, or information about what it's going to do, you simply select there and it will tell you exactly what it is. Here we have our pet detection, just like it sounds, keep an eye for your pets. Abnormal sound, mainly for crying babies, but if there's a loud bang or something like that that's out of the ordinary, it will send you a notification. Gesture recognition. This is the weird one that everybody else who I've seen review this camera says it's a neat feature, but they don't know why it's really there. I have thought of something why this could be very good to have as part of this camera, and that's being Let's say you have a small child who does not yet have a cell phone of their own, and you, like me, get bombarded with notifications all the time from things like this. You kind of miss one or don't pay attention to it. If you turn on gesture control and you have somebody wave at the camera, small child waves at the camera, well, guess what? Then it will call the application through your phone and give you a voice call with the person. So small child needs to get in contact with you, you're not paying attention to your notifications, they wave at the camera and force you to pay attention. That is the best use of this that I can think of, or hypothetically a pet sitter that doesn't have your phone number, as odd as that might be. But that's an interesting feature of the C6. Coming down, we have our notifications. Well, we have audible notifications. Right now I have it muted, but you can have it up intense, soft, custom sound, configure audible warning, and then you kind of have a speaker here that you can drag. I have them all off because I don't want it, but it's there. Message notification, you have to receive device messages in order to actually get the library, which I'll show you in a moment, but you gotta turn that on. Device message interval, so you can change this. Right now I have it at its minimum of 1 minute between notifications, or you can set it all the way up to 30 minutes. I have this on too. Ezviz app notification, and then configure notification. I have it disabled, but there's a lot of extra things that you can do for the push notifications. You can set up specific times, days, a lot of customization here. And then you have offline notifications. I have that off because, well, I just want it when it's online. Moving on, we have our audio. Well, you gotta enable that because, well, you wanna hear what's going on, you gotta turn that on. Device voice prompt, you probably heard that during the setup process, that's what that is. Image, selecting this, we have, well, this is gonna be our live view right now. You have your WDR setting, which is for better image effect when background or backlighting scenes, so like this, kind of a mixture. If I turn that on, you can see it changes the way it looks. I'm gonna turn that off again, so you can see, kind of changes. You can see this is dark over here because there's a lot of white light coming out of there. Turn that back on one more time so you can see. And notice that mutes it, and that over there now looks kind of less washed out. And then here you have OSD. When enabled, OSD with the device name will be displayed on all videos captured. So that's right up there. If you don't like that, simply toggle it off and it's no longer there. And then you have the ability to flip your image. So if you're mounting this upside down on a ceiling, you can flip the image so that you're actually looking at it correctly. And we're gonna flip that back, and selecting back one more time, we have our lights. We have our camera status light, which we can turn off, which I might recommend doing only because the light on the front blinking instead of being a steady light kind of annoys me. I wish they would change that, but again, just food for thought. Here we have our PTZ settings. That's gonna be our movement settings. We have auto tracking. Now, if you were trying to find how to get the camera to follow you, this is turned off by default, but come into the PZ settings, turn that on, and now the camera will follow you and push in when it detects a human, as long as you have those AI events enabled. You have your fixed view, so the lens will not rotate when tracking. We have our flexible view, the lens will rotate while following human movement, and then we have our position calibration and our 360 picture. So again, we were here before, this is just another way to access it, and then our position calibration will have it go through and move so that it's actually true center. Very nice. All right, coming down, we have our general. We have cloud storage, if you so chose to use it. Again, there's a 7-day free trial right here, and it lets you know all the things that you can get with that trial. I particularly like the fact that you have the SD card, which is right here. Here's our record list. If we come in here, we have our cloud storage, we have our memory card, and we have all day. So it could do all day recording, or it could do clips. Selecting the memory card, just so you know, lets us know how much space has been used. We can reformat it, and it lets you know it's normal, so we're all good, all things are green. We have our security settings, so video encryption, and then we can change our encryption password. If you set it up, don't worry about it. We have our network right there, that's my IoT network. We have our device information, as you might imagine, lots of sensitive information there, won't be showing you, but that's where you go to find it. And then we have share the device. Selecting that will allow you to send a share request to a person who also has the Ezviz app. We can restart the device and delete the device from here. And selecting back, those were all of our options for the Ezviz C6. We're gonna select back one more time and talk about down here. This is our device list. We have our library. Again, the library will not be populated unless first you turn on notifications. That was one of the things that was frustrating me for a little bit, because all of these past days I had no data because no notifications were being pushed, because I was trying to not have to push notifications when you have like four different cameras sending you notifications at once. And here you can see it's kind of letting you know I was doing things. So here's pet detected, even though it was upside down. It's gonna let you know all of that, and it lets you know the name of the camera in case you have multiple cameras. Next tab over is automation. You can set up lots of automations with this. I have not done this myself, but there are plenty of videos, one linked in the corner, that lets you know what you can do with this. It's kind of cool. Coming back to our device list, we're gonna come over to the upper left-hand corner because we talked about this really quickly. This is our profile. You have your My Profile, My Albums, General Settings, Family and Guest, CloudPlay, Ezviz Drive, Smart Integration, so you can integrate this with Alexa, Google, and IFTTT. Again, about the app, you have new features, the app recently updated, so it's telling you all the new things that you can do. You have Help Center, you have feedback, and you have a live chat option right there. Each of these will have lots of extra things that you can do, such as if we come up quickly to general settings, you've got language, you've got dark mode, you've got device auto update, save. I'm not going to dig into those. Just know if you're looking for things like that for the application itself rather than the individual device, that's where you go. And this has been a rather long look at the Ezviz app for the Ezviz C6 2K+.